Good morning, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. The town of Sandown will be spraying for mosquitoes tonight after a mosquito pool tested positive for West Nile virus in that community. The spraying will take place at local schools and recreation areas starting at 5:30. People are being urged to stay away. This is the second community to see the disease this season after Pelham. Residents are urged to take precautions to avoid mosquito bites. The new Memorial Bridge, it opens today. The bridge connecting Portsmouth to Kittery has been under construction for some time now. At 11 a.m. today, a special ribbon-cutting ceremony will officially open the bridge. Pedestrians and cyclists will then have a chance to explore the bridge before it opens to vehicle traffic. Hundreds of Granite Staters are being warned that a bartender may have exposed them to hepatitis A. The infected employee worked part-time in Contoocook at the Covered Bridge Restaurant and the American Legion. State health officials estimate that between 600 to 1,000 people will have to be vaccinated for potential exposure. Those people would have been customers at the Covered Bridge Restaurant or the Contoocook American Legion between July 20th and August 3rd.
If they work well, being diagnosed with hepatitis A or during the incubation period, even if they have no symptoms, there is a risk of transmission of the disease to those who will receive uncooked food.
Hepatitis A is more easily transferred than hepatitis C, but it is also more treatable. You can contract the virus from close contact or contaminated food or water. Symptoms include fever, nausea, vomiting, dark urine, joint pain, and jaundice. The Centers for Disease Control says the best way to prevent the virus is to wash your hands often. For people who are more at risk, vaccination is the best way to prevent infection. The Department of Health and Human Services will be providing clinics to vaccinate people who may have been exposed. The clinics will be held at Hopkinton High School this Friday between 12 and 8 p.m. and on Saturday between 9 a.m. and 2 p.m. Well, WMUR is teaming up with the New Hampshire Fisher Cats tonight for Play Ball for Chad, a special game that raises money for the Children's Hospital at Dartmouth. The game starts at 7:05. There will be plenty of family activities and a fireworks show after the game. Tickets start at $6, and 50% of their proceeds benefit the Children's Hospital at Dartmouth. Several people are being hailed as heroes after reviving a teenager who stopped breathing at Waterville Valley last month. On July 25th, a 14-year-old boy became unconscious and stopped breathing after finishing some drills on a trampoline as part of a summer ski camp. An instructor immediately noticed something was wrong, and a group of people began CPR. A ski patrol member came over with a portable defibrillator, and the young man was brought back to life.
Called for a shock, pressed the button, and immediately he gasped his first breath after a while. So it's exciting to see him come back.
Thank God he came back to life. It was truly a miracle.
Officials say that young man has recovered and is doing fine. Yesterday, those involved in saving the teen's life were presented awards and a new defibrillator device. And that's your morning webcast. We'll have an update at 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.